is all very good and well, but how did the angels wind up there? Why was Christ born anyway? Will someone tell me this?
Sure. You see, there's a path leading to Bethlehem and to Christ. You just have to follow the trail markers. Come on. Here we are, Genesis.
So God created mankind in his own image and his own likeness. Male and female, God created them.
Yes, but Adam and Eve ate from the tree which God told them was forbidden. They were punished for their sin, and God wouldn't let them stay in Eden.
Therefore, the Lord sent them from the Garden of Eden to till the ground from which he was taken. God drove out man, and at the east of the garden, he placed a cherubim and a flaming sword that turned every way to guard the way to the tree of life.
But what's that got to do with Christmas?
Everything. After all, we haven't gotten kicked out of Eden. Why should we need a savior?
Do you remember Noah and how God made a covenant with him?
I establish my covenant with you. Never again shall we have flood to destroy the earth.
The rainbow is a symbol of the covenant between God and every living creature.
God loved Noah and saved him and his family and the animals from the destruction of God's anger at sin.
That's great for Noah, but
let's go on. There's more to see.
Father of a multitude of nations. I will make nations of you. Kings will come forth from you.
So what?
Don't you see? God loved us so much that he kept trying to bring us back to him with his covenants.
Here's the next path marker.
That's just the Ten Commandments.
You shall not take the name of the Lord your God. Sabbath day to keep it holy. Honor your father and your mother. You shall not kill. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not bear false testimony against your neighbor. You shall not covet your neighbor's house. You shall not covet anything that belongs to your neighbor.
Right, this is God's law, the tablets of the covenant, which he gave so that he could make Israel his people.
Now I'm really confused. What light? This...
What?
Okay, what's next? This still doesn't make much sense.
This next step should help. It symbolizes God's promise to David.
When your days are fulfilled and you lie down with your fathers, I'll raise up your son after you. I will establish his kingdom. He shall build a house for my name, and I will establish the throne of his kingdom forever.
Yes, see here, the flame stands for the prophecy of Isaiah.
The people who are out in darkness have seen a great light.
Those that dwell in a land of deep darkness, unto them light has shined. You have multiplied the nations, you have increased his joy. They rejoice before you. For the yoke of his burden and the staff of his shoulder, for the rod of the oppressor you have broken, as on the day of Midian.
For unto us a child is born, to us a son is given.
And the government shall be on his shoulders, and this is his name will be called.
Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Of the increase of his government and peace there will be no end, upon the throne of David and over his kingdom, and to uphold it with justice and righteousness from this time forth and forevermore.
The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
Now I'm really confused. What light? Whose child?
Isaiah was talking about Jesus, the son promised to David.
This branch is the path marker that points to Christ, too.
A branch? What's a tree got to do with this?
Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when I fulfill the promise I made to the house of Israel and to the house of Judah. In those days I cause a righteous branch to spring forth from David, and he shall execute justice in the land. For this by name is what it shall be called.
The Lord is our righteousness.
I think I see. But why Bethlehem? And where are those angels?
We're getting close to the end of our path and the answers to all your questions. You see, Jesus was God's final promise to us, his final answer to all the other signs we've seen. Because humans are sinful, we can never succeed in keeping God's commandments or covenants. But God sent out to fulfill his promises to us and sent us Jesus.
Here's one of your angels.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary.
And he said, "Hail, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what sort of greeting this might be.
And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in the womb and bear a son. You shall call his name Jesus.
He will be great and be called Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David. And of his kingdom there will be no end."
Just like the earlier covenants.
"And behold, your kinswoman Elizabeth in her old age has also gave birth to a son. For this is the sixth month with her who she was called barren. For nothing will be impossible with God."
And Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaiden of the Lord. Let it be to me according to your word." And the angel departed from her.
That wasn't a herald angel. The angel didn't even sing. There must be more. Besides, the song says angels, plural, not just one.
Well, here's where another angel comes in.
A bed? What's a bed got to do with it? Listen. Now, the birth of Jesus Christ took place in this way.
When his mother Mary had been betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found to be with child of the Holy Spirit. And her, Joseph, being a just man and unwilling to put her to shame, resolved to divorce her quietly.
But as he considered this, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying,
Joseph, son of David, do not fear to take Mary as your wife, for which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit, and she will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save the people from their sins.
When Joseph woke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took his wife, but knew her not until she had borne a son. He called his name Jesus.
See how close we are? We're almost there. They're on their way to Bethlehem.
In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration when Quirinius, the governor of Syria, each went to his own town to be registered.
And Joseph also went out from Galilee, from Judea, from the city of Nazareth, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the same house and lineage of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was his child.
So that's where Bethlehem fits in. It all goes back to David and God's covenant with him.
At last, Christ is born.
And the time came for her to be delivered, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
And there were in that region shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night.
This is great, but I know. Where are the angels? They're right here.
And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord was shown around them, and they were filled with fear. And the angel said to them, "Be not afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy, which will come to all the people.
For to you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger."
And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying,
"Glory to God in the highest, and all people."
At last, the angels. Next on our journey.
With the shepherds, we journey to the manger.
And when the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go and see this thing that has happened that the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and a babe lying in a manger.
Why aren't we stopping? Isn't this the end?
Nope. Just one more part of the path. It's very important. Here it is.
We're going to play the trumpet?
Sort of. You see, God has been so good to us that we want to share the good news the way the shepherds did.
And when they saw it, they made known the saying that had been told to them concerning this child, and all who heard it wondered what the shepherds told them.
Mary kept all these things, pondering them in her heart.
And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told to them.
We want to let others know Jesus is King and Savior, just as the angels told the shepherds.
You mean we should praise God? Well, why don't we do something about it?
Do you have any ideas?
Sure. Let's sing Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
You mean without interruptions this time?
Yeah, all the way through.